Don't catch on fire, please.
I just have to mention we're all gathered here to celebrate the union of Katie and Michael. I know for me, I always thought that they just kind of existed. There is hard to imagine there was a before. There was just Katie and Michael. But there was a before. And actually, it's quite interesting because when they first met through Jessica and Richard, Jessica had warned Katie that Michael was a ladies' man. And what Katie did from there was say, oh, hell no. this man is, I'm going to give him all that I've got. And so she played hard to get. Meanwhile, at the time, Jessica, Richard, we were all hanging out, and the rest of us could see that they really liked each other, but for some reason they were too proud, and this went on for a year. When we were just like, seriously, get it over with. Get it over with. Well, I guess what happened, I asked Jessica today, she had said that they had all planned on going to a movie together, but Jessica and Richard bailed at the last minute and said, hey, you and Michael should go anyway, and so they did. And then from there, the rest is history. And I just have to say this. Even though I think it's hilarious the way that they got together, and the way that they act towards one another, I do have to say one of the things that I love about being around Katie and Michael is just how much they make each other laugh. And it's infectious. It's contagious. They're so much fun to be around. And after being together almost 12 years, it's actually quite amazing just that they crack each other up. Are their jokes inappropriate sometimes? Of course. But are we Graysons and are we Jerowitzes? It's to be expected. So it's a true match. But they're truly an inspiration to me because I think, as we all know, the best relationships are ones in which not only are you partners and lovers, but you're best friends. And I just can't imagine either of them being with anyone else. So I'm very grateful to be here with all of you to join their union. That's all I have to say about that. I have to mention, feel free anyone else to make speeches after this, but we're going to make this quick. We're going to exchange the vows. And Katie and Michael have picked out a vow for the Reverend Angela Grayson. I, Katie, do pledge to you, Michael, my love for as long as we both shall live.
I, Katie, do pledge to you, Michael, my love for as long as we both shall live.
What I possess in this world, I give to you.
What I possess in this world, I give to you.
I will keep you and hold you, comfort you and tend you, protect you and shelter you for all the days to come. I will keep you and hold you.
I will keep you and hold you.
Protect you and shelter you.
Protect you and shelter you.
For all the days of my life.
For all the days of my life.
Richard.
Sarah, appreciate that.
I, Michael.
Perfect. I, Michael.
Do pledge to you, Katie, my love for as long as we both shall live.
Do pledge to you, Katie.
What I possess in this world, I give to you.
What I possess in this world, I give to you.
I will keep you and hold you.
I will keep you and hold you.
Comfort you and tend to you.
Comfort you and tend to you.
Protect you and shelter you.
Protect you and shelter you.
For all the days of my life.
For all the days of my life.
Now, by the power vested in me by the state of New Mexico, what were they thinking? It is my honor to declare you man and wife. You may seal your union. I am pleased to present Mr. and Mrs. Jerowitz. And now we meet. And I want to say a special thank you to Gabby and Andy for the beautiful.
Thank you guys. Thank you, everyone.
All right, we did it. Let's party.